Welcome back to part two of my playing Planescape Torment. I've made a few changes in the way I record the stream, and I'm hopeful that this way the quality of the sound recording is going to be a lot better. This seems to take advantage of the multi-processing capabilities better. Just quickly, here's the OpenBSD FAQ on multimedia framework. And what I'm leveraging here is recording audio samples, essentially, from the monitoring stream, kind of this way. I record one with AUCAT from the monitoring stream, another one from the microphone. This is one of the great things about OpenBSD, that you have a lot of like simple but very useful low level tools for the command line that are very in the tradition of like the Unix philosophy. So with that said, here's my new script for recording. So you see here's a couple of like prior attempts, but essentially AUCAT for the two audio streams, and then ffmpeg for the video stream in three separate files, which I'm later going to merge with something like this. Essentially adjusting the volume, trying to get rid of some of the background white noise. I think that's because of the microphone, that's not greatest quality. Merging the audio inputs, and then just adding that to the MP4 file format, and we'll see how that works. With that being said, let's get started. Okay, I'll let the intro video run a little bit, so just for the sake of comparison of the audio quality. Here's still some stuttering as I'm playing it. Here, and you probably get the best idea here in the main menu and as I play the game. So let's resume our nameless safe game, and here we are back, the nameless one and Mort.
I must be hallucinating all this.
Not sure if you're hallucinating all this, buddy. What's special about the female corpses? Oh, it's for Mort or Morty himself. Okay. Can't be serious. We already got an opening line. I guess he's including me as like the nameless one who has kind of died, or maybe died, or looked like he was dead. Just say before that I'm not dead. You can see how there's some morbid undertones here. Who are these caretakers? The dust. Oh. Black and rigor mortis of the face. Ghoulish death worshippers. Okay, got everything. Okay, we checked this out the last time. You can open the quick menu with a right click anywhere, and then you can choose the dialog option and click on Mort, for example. I think it's going to be a while until we get another party member. Okay, new journal. So here's the journal screen. Quests, find Pharaoh. Find your missing journal. Complete it. Nothing. Beasts. Morte. Okay, there's a nameless one. That's me. What about NPC? Zombie. You can kill a normal human being with a single punch. Okay. Journal. Okay, not much in here yet. Okay. Around it a little bit.
All right.
Hey, zombie worker. Okay. I got it. Mark
Done.
Is an expert in reading
Done.
Other dead people. What is this one here?
All right.
Contribute. They're all not exactly talkative.
Done. I'm gone.
The rule of three. Yeah, who gets in there? Well, let's see, what is rule of three? Things tend to happen in threes. Everything's composed of three parts, so there's always three choices, and so on and so forth. World of Wash, yeah, maybe it's a little superstitious. I wonder if they also think that this would go for a number like 7,658. Okay, well,
I'm gone.
Here's another door.
I'm gone. I'm gone.
This one just opens. Let's take a look at the map. Okay, I think this has a circular layout. We're on the second floor, actually. from here.
I'm gone.
Bandages. Or it's to get more bandages.
Done.
Receive a room of work. What might be in there? Let's take a look. Just a manual. Okay, receiving room is where possessions are stored. They're going to be in the logbook. So maybe we'll get an idea of what we came in with. The last page had cut out. Interesting. I mean, it doesn't really like help me in any way at this point, but it adds to the whole thing. Like, why would somebody cut out the last page? Right. Are they trying to hide something? So for me, got enough bandages for now.
I had to wake up from the dead in a place like this. I'm gone.
Hey, as far as I remember, there are a few that have something of interest. Maybe this one? Corner of a note stuck in the corpse's mouth. That's interesting. Okay. Let's go with the picture. Zombie's mouth. If you tried to pull the paper out of your crossers, it would tear the paper to shreds. To find a delicate way. Okay, let's see if I can use the scalpel to cut this. Okay, I guess this is a dexterity test. That passed, apparently, judging from the sound that just happened. Is there anything else? Okay. Now the jaw is hanging open, a trail of ichor is trickling from the corner of its mouth. Okay, yeah, I'm sorry. Who knows if there's a soul in there at all? Here's a big book. Let's first take a look at our inventory. Note from corpse 1201. Okay, it seems like the person did not want to be raised as a zombie worker, but they were anyway, if I'm reading this correctly. I think they mean the talk to item button. Now I'm wondering if this is maybe related to GemRB not putting the right label on it. But let's see. Strange looking diagram describing its writing. one mark on the upper right, two marks on the lower right, three marks on the lower left, and no marks on the upper left. Let's start with upper left then. I mean, it's programmers who made this game, so I assume they just start with zero. They start counting with zero, unlike normal people. So let's start with the upper left and see if that works. I think it was upper right, lower right, lower left. Wait. Upper right, lower right, lower left. For a moment I thought maybe it's related to the number of the zombie, but that doesn't make any sense, and there's no 3 in there. Upper right, lower right, lower left, upper left. I'll leave it alone for now.
Done.
Okay, nothing here. This is just my belongings.
All right.
I keep this as a recall. I'll leave this one in peace. Here's another one.
I must be hallucinating all this.
Jaw is missing. Some of the flesh has slid off her skull. 1072 chiseled into the bone. Okay, I guess it doesn't have anything to say. Huh?
I'm gone.
About that.
I'm gone.
Okay, here's someone who's not as dead as the others. Let's just save while we're here.
Had to wake up from the dead in a place like this.
Oh, Mortis. Rattling your bone box with dusties. Okay, he doesn't seem to be in good health. Let's leave. The weight of years hangs heavy upon me, restless one. I do not yet count deafness among my names. Restless one, do you know me? There's a trace of bitterness in the scribe's voice. Okay, apparently I forgot something. That was me, restless one. What about the mortuary? My wounds, huh? I don't You would think he was royalty based on the number of loyal subjects at least. Thinking Fester can play the card that carried you. Okay. Farad. I don't have no idea what a seneschal is. Who's he? He's a collector of the dead. Maybe he makes money with me here, since I'm apparently a frequent customer. Takes liberties with the possessions of the dead. Mate of the coast. Thief. I don't know why they call that a knight of the post. Less their dignity than they possess in life, or takes whatever he may pry from their stiffening fingers. To take anything from me, most likely. I am missing her journal there. Okay, we're gonna find him. Well, he says do not seek out Farad. Things that will come full circle again. Thinks, oh, this is like Farad is enriching himself. Except death. Okay, I guess that's how dustmen talk. The circle of misery. Somewhere beyond the mortuary gates in the hive. Okay, let's see. Close to a true death. Okay. How can I get out of here? They will not let anyone other than dustmen pass. One of the guides, but a funky has a key. Unless I'm extremely persuasive. I don't know how persuasive I can be. Well, a huge book. This is the map. This one's a sad story. Okay. Oh, I guess we'll get a little bit of view here, but there's a large pit in the center.
Done. I'm gone.
I think we're not gonna go much. Maybe finish this level of the mortuary.
All right. Done. I'm gone. I had to wake up from the
end
dead
this
in a
episode.
Place like that. I'm
here. Probably
done.
These games they usually fill stuff with something of interest. It looks like
done.
There's just a zombie worker here.
Done.
Looks like he died only recently. Librarian carrying a huge stack of books. What books? A loose page folded between two of the books. It looks like someone tucked it there to hide it. Looks like it belongs in a lockbook. Maybe it's the last page that was torn out. Probably.
All appear to be recent arrivals.
Okay, is there anything else on the zombie? Just one. Okay. Collect the pox, devour it. I guess mine would have like the all the scars or the quasi journal on the back of on my back. Something the kind must have mentioned there. Devour it. Copper earring found lodged in abdomen. Locked in southeast preparation room. Strange markings like those on worker number 79. Okay, preparation room. Maybe we can find something there. Okay, not much here. Let's return.
All right. I'm gone. All right. I'm gone. Foot in the grave, the other in hell.
Okay, doesn't look like this one has anything special about him. There's a dust woman, or dust man.
All right.
Let's see first if there's anything else. Bandages.
All right. All right. All right.
I remember the pathfinding wasn't the best in this game. Let's safe before we go there. Fingers are talons. Bit short of hearing. She's a tiefling. Greetings. Terribly nearsighted. Find thread and embalming juice, and I got a quest. Journal. Side quest. Okay, and here. Yeah, we must be able to find something in Mortuary.
I'm gone.
Let's examine this one a little. I'm sure this is the population. Okay.
Alright. Done.
This can't be opened.
I'm gone.
There's another zombie worker. Let's look at the stitches. The new lid, of course, is for the flip. Okay. The number 78. Okay.
Done.
I think that's a quest item. Quick look. Oh, I'm gonna heal 6 hit points. Some sort of tomb rot or corpse mold has eaten through its knee. Let's see if we can put. Okay, that went wrong. Nobody seems to have noticed. Okay.
All right.
This looks very much like Baldur's Gate. Left arm. Ah. system. Okay. This is Baldur's Gate, I think. The one, it's yellow, and you can just double click to select the weapon that you want to make your primary weapon. It's convenient that I have four weapon slots. Try one more thing here. Okay. Just want to count down now. Like three. Lower left. Two. Lower right. One is upper right.
I said that made death reject. I'm gone. I wonder what it was I said that made death reject me.
Okay, let's leave this one alone.
I'm gone.
See. I think I can run with shift. No?
Done. Alright.
So.
Alright.
Stairs.
All right. I'm gone. Done.
Okay. There's a tomb.
All right.
Okay. So what's in this machine? Embalming fluid. Do we have all the quest items now? So,
I'm gone. I'm gone. All right. I'm gone.
You can see how, like, the atmosphere is very morbid. Oh, I learned something. Number 42, that must be special. You're standing in front of it. Okay. Place something inside it. These things safe. If we gained a memory. Experience points, skills. Okay. Okay, so or she takes the items. Let's wait. Playing zombie is not the worst strategy. She examines my scars. Okay, so she's stitching up my scars. Makes me feel better. Oh, Mort. Did I just gain? That upgrade, I guess, or something. My constitution. I think I got a hit point. I think it was 24 before. Maybe that's it. Okay, let's see what we find here. I think we should be able to finish this level up pretty soon.
I'm gone.
And see where those stairs lead us. More embalming fluid. What does it do, actually? Hit points and armor class. I guess that's only temporary. Effects are temporary. Okay, so I'll keep it around.
All right.
This container is locked.
All right.
So I guess this is the one where the ring must be that they mentioned before.
Foot in the grave, the other in hell. Done. Done. I'm gone. Done.
Can I attack the store?
Done. All right.
Did I check this one?
I'm gone.
Apparently. Okay, take a quick look. Down.
we have
corpse number 42 that contains something. Let me see if I can attack the chest.
Alright.
Oh. And it has an earring. Okay, I cannot use the red now because it's closed. No hook or any means of actual attachment to the ear. Okay, this is the talk to item. But grooves are evenly spaced. Small things. Man-made. Let's see if I may have an idea.
Right.
After that, we'll wrap it up.
I had to wake up from the dead in a place like this.
I wonder what that room is here.
I'm gone.
Oh, Eric. Oh, interesting. I don't feel like lying to him. I don't have a good reason right now. Okay, I guess helping each other out is a reasonable proposal usually. Okay, yeah, where's this key? The dusty with yellow eyes. Plates on her fingers. Not exactly
right.
Nice.
One foot in the grave, the other in hell. I'm gone.
That's safe before we talk with her.
Done.
Okay, so we got the key.
Done.
Let me see.
I wonder what it was I said that made. I wonder what it was I said that made death reject me. Done.
fire out this key. See if it works with this.
I wonder what it was I said that made death reject me.
Mortar is much faster than this one.
I'm gone.
This is not the key.
I'm gone.
Let's just give it to the guy.
All right.
Yeah, let's just close the loop here.
All right. Done. I wonder what it was I said that made death reject me.
Portals? What portals? Go to arch on first floor, northwest room. Hunger bone chain of croak. Guess that's the key. Go to arch, jump to secret crypt. Secret escape route. And rest there. Look in the storage rooms on the upper floor, maybe there. Okay, with embalming fluid and some needle and thread, I can make me look like a zombie. I don't know where he gets the debtors. Okay, but he's been killing people. I guess they talk a little bit of a jargon there. Okay, well, that concludes it for today for me. Thank you. And we'll quit the game. Alright, so we made some progress. See you next time.